Greetings. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. My talk today focuses on temperature-driven range loss, especially in tricky situations like airports when you leave your car. Bonjour, wie geht's? Wie steht's noch? Im Allsweibahnen. Strasvice. Guten Tag. Buongiorno. This is Greg for Tesla Fan Insight. One of the areas that one has to manage when you're an electric car driver is range and range anxiety. I was fascinated by the fact that I had a friend whose partner owns a top-of-the-line Model S and is a doctor. So one of the challenges they ran into was the fact that if he had to work overnight in the hospital by the time he got out, and it was sub-zero in Chicago, he'd almost have no range or might have to flatbed his vehicle to get electricity for it. And so I then asked, you know, what kind of range loss he was experiencing. And he said that he was losing as much as half of his range during sub-freezing zones in Chicago. So I was kind of struck by that because I was like, wow, that is a lot. And it definitely is a consideration as you're purchasing. If your work doesn't give you the overnight charging ability, you don't have a supercharger in your building that the condo he lives in doesn't allow them to put in a higher speed charger, so he's limited to a 110. I actually went and visited recently the Tesla facility in Washington, D.C. and spoke with someone there. And in January, when it was below freezing, I asked the question about this loss of range, and one of the people there had told me that the range loss in that at or below freezing is about 7 miles of range per day. And I thought that was sounded about right. Another person had said, as I said, an owner had experienced about 50% range loss. The main reason for the big range loss is something called battery conditioning. The vehicle will actually use the battery life to condition the battery, either to warm it up in the cold zones or cool it down in very hot days, I would say above 100, in order to make the chemical reaction that's needed for the energy transfer to occur between battery and car occur. So this battery conditioning can result in loss of distance. So not only do you lose distance in terms of the car just sitting there and you know running things like the alarm, clocks, etc., but you also lose distance in this battery conditioning process. It was interesting because when I checked in with the gentleman in DC, he was like, oh, there's no problem. You can just sit your car there and it'll just act like a regular car in terms of battery loss. And I know that's definitely not the case. So I think it's worth the time to sort of look around at other owners in forums and their experiences with battery loss in whatever region you live in, because the management process and understanding what that is will be very helpful. One of the areas in particular that I've been fascinated by regarding range loss is in airport situations. I lived in the San Francisco Bay Area for a number of years, and we have what are called microclimates. So that means that within a 50-mile radius, there are 11 different microclimates, and the temperature can be anywhere from 30 to 80 degrees at the same time during the day. One spot that's fascinating for this is the San Francisco airport, because it sits right on the water, and the winds that come off that water, particularly at night, can result in the temperatures dropping below freezing while your car is sitting inside the airport parking area. So if you go on a business trip, let's say, and you're out for 5 days, in theory you could lose 7 times 5 worth of sort of range for those 5 days, and then add in the fact that if it's below freezing when you get back to your car, you could lose half your range from that. So if your distance home or to a charger is beyond a certain number, you could end up with a car that's dead before you return, or that's got very little battery left to it once you pull in. In fact, one tip might be to consider parking in a place where a flatbed can get to your car, because that might enhance your ability to make it back to your destination by a flatbed pulling in and picking your vehicle up and taking it to a charging facility or taking it to your house. Another solution that's been arrived at is, for example, at Kennedy Airport in New York now, there's actually a charging facility at the airport. So superchargers at the airport is one way Tesla is addressing this issue. I think it's worth sort of thinking through what happens, because certainly I know a lot about loss of range of the cold side of it. Have not seen or experienced situations where people live in very hot places, but in the summertime in Texas or California or other parts of the world near deserts, you're likely to see that top-end problem, meaning I think above 100 degrees, you may start seeing disappearing range that was unexpected, and that's being consumed by the battery trying to cool itself down so that it can transfer energy, and that cooling process can wipe out a bunch of range that you thought you had had. I was also fascinated because you know, understanding how the cells operate, the ideal temperatures they want to operate in, et cetera, can be helpful in the process of vehicle ownership and being mindful of solutions to these problems. I think is a really smart move, because what I've noticed is that owners and their experiences with managing this problem tend to be a better source of information than when I went to meet with professionals at the Tesla store. So I just think it's a smart space to put some time and energy to think about, because if you don't have charging facilities near you, etc., and even if you do, I think the car may behave in ways that were unexpected. One last item on this that I thought was really interesting was that the New York Times had a reporter who got a Tesla for a few days and got in the vehicle, and it was winter time, and he made a bunch of rookie mistakes in terms of how he managed the car, and the net result was that he started having disappearing range, as we discussed. So the Tesla representative that he was in touch with actually, you know, he had maybe 100 miles to go or 80 miles to go. His range was showing less than that. So the recommendation from the Tesla rep was to shut off the heater and actually in the car and actually go ahead and start perhaps using heat in the seat, but not for the whole vehicle. So I thought that was an interesting technique that was used. The reporter also experienced sudden disappearance of range, because they parked at a destination overnight, and when he got back in the car, the overnight time or distance that had been given had changed by the time he decided to leave in the morning. So this created some real sort of white knuckle driving on his part, and he made it finally to his destination, but he learned a lesson regarding making sure you plug it in overnight in cold temperatures, even if you have enough range to get where you go or you think you have that range, because moderate temperatures are easy for this to work, but if the temperatures are really cold, you can suddenly see range you thought you had completely disappear. I'm actually looking forward to a response to this, because I think there are folks that live in very hot places that might have some empirical feedback that I don't have on this issue. But it would be helpful, I think, for everyone to hear what the experiences of those folks might be. I want to thank you for taking time out once again to visit with us. This is Greg at Tesla Fan Insight. Tschüss, mach's gut, au revoir, tout à l'heure, la hitrote. Please like and subscribe. always helpful to hear topics that you'd like to have covered. I think, you know, there can be range anxiety even with Teslas, particularly in very cold weather, and it's worth understanding how to best manage this. Thanks and have a great day. Look forward to our next conversation.